The music you're hearing is by a man who was a mystic. He had visions of creating a work of art that would combine not only music, but the dance, visual colors, religious ritual, and his theories of Oriental mysticism. Unfortunately for his plans, this man, whose ideas were so grandiose and so otherworldly, died from so unglamorous a thing as a boil on his lip. Early in his career, he wrote works that sounded just like Chopin. In fact, because of that, he became known as the Russian Chopin. Later on, he developed his own style and his own musical theories, and he began to write compositions based on certain chords which he created. The work you're hearing is based on one of those chords, and it was one of his attempts to associate sounds and colors. It was originally intended to be accompanied by a keyboard of light. The work is called Prometheus, the Poem of Fire. The composer was Alexander Scriabin. Scriabin's Prometheus has been recorded on LP for the first time by the New York Philharmonic Symphony Orchestra under the direction of Dimitri Mitropoulos, with Leonid Hambro as piano soloist. Of course, it's impossible to convey on a recording any idea of Scriabin's intentions regarding his use of colored lights in this music. But thanks to Columbia's high-fidelity recording techniques, the disc certainly captures the musical colors in the score. In this sample of the climax of the work, notice with what power the music emerges. Side of this disc containing Scriabin's Prometheus, the Poem of Fire, the New York Philharmonic Symphony Orchestra has also recorded another Scriabin work under Dimitri Mitropoulos. It's his Poem of Ecstasy, in which the important trumpet part is played by William Vacchiano. For lovers of the exotic in music, this record is quite a find. Music by another Russian composer has been issued by Columbia this month. It's by Prokofiev, whose death deprived us of one of the truly great musical minds of our time. Prokofiev went through various stages in his development, as do most composers, and at one time he wrote music that bristled with discord. Back around 1914, he was very much influenced by Stravinsky's Rite of Spring, which I mentioned on the other side of this record. Well, because of his early tendency toward the creation of rather extreme types of music, I find it interesting to see some of the trends of Prokofiev's later works. Here's the opening of his Sonata for Violin and Piano, his Opus 94. And notice what gentle, introspective music Prokofiev wrote. This gives the feeling of being almost improvised. There's nothing strained about it. It has the poise of a man who is a master of his art. This sonata by Prokofiev is played by the violinist Isaac Stern and the pianist Alexander Zakin. And on the other side of the disc, the same two artists have recorded another sonata by Prokofiev, the Opus 80. On last month's preview record, I mentioned the limited edition of the chamber works that had been recorded at the Prades Festival under the direction of Pablo Casals. Well, this month, an album containing the first three records is being made available generally. This set includes the following works: the Schumann Quintet for Piano and Strings, the Brahms Quintet Opus 111, the Brahms Sextet Opus 18, and the same composer's Piano Quartet Opus 60. That last work is performed by the violinist Joseph Zighetti, the violist Milton Kadams, the cellist Paul Tortelier, and the pianist Myra Hess. And here's a sample of that recording.